To all my friends returning, I'd like to say welcome back. To those who are just now finding me, I'd like to say welcome. We're going to walk through my garden today up here in the orchards. I call this garden number two, or my orchard garden. And we're going to talk about some of the successes, failures, and problems that I've had. Here is one of my problems in, this year I consider failure. These are baby bear pumpkins. They are small, sweet pie pumpkins that are very, very good. I love these things, but they have a problem. I've grown these for the last 3 years, and they seem to be very susceptible to powdery mildew. I have to pay very, very close attention to them, even in a good year. Last year was a very good year. I mean, it was perfect. This year has been very wet, very overcast. For every 15 days of rain, I might get 3 days of sunshine. It's just been bad. I've treated these with powdery mildew several times, but it's pretty much destroyed it anyway. This is going to be probably my last year for even trying it. I really hate that because I love these things. Hokkaido pumpkins, or maybe it's Hokkaido. Possibly these are a good alternative to my baby bear. They're small, sweet pumpkins, supposed to be good for soups. This is my first year for planting these. They seem to be hardy. They're producing well. The only problem I have right now is the yellowing on the leaves seem to indicate a deficiency in magnesium, potassium, and other trace minerals. That's a problem with the soil, though, not with the plant. The plant seems to be doing quite well. These are my butternut squash. This is my third year growing these, and I've got no complaints with these at all, other than they tend to take over the garden if you don't watch out for them. They seem to be pretty hardy. You do have to watch out for powdery mildew, as with any other curcubite, but they seem to be fairly resistant this year. We're moving here into an experimental portion of my garden. I'm trying to experiment here with a system referred to as the Three Sisters Gardening. I have tried several different mounds where I planted a combination of corn, beans, and I had the pumpkins or squash growing around and down through them. The beans were supposed to feed nitrogen into the corn, which the corn requires high nitrogen. The beans feed the feed nitrogen into the ground. From the looks of the corn, it looks like it has done very, very well. Corn is tasseling out very nice. There are other corn in the area that was planted the same time as these, and they're not looking as nice yet. We're moving over here now into my potatoes. I grow potatoes every year. This is the first year in this particular patch of ground that I've grown these. I try to rotate them every 2 years. These are looking pretty good. And since the filming of this, I have actually taken the potatoes out of the ground where you are seeing this. If you saw my potato dig video, this is where I actually dug them out. The potatoes did well this year. I've had very little problems with the potato bugs. And surprisingly, even though we've had a lot of rain and moisture, I've had no potato blight this year. I'm moving over into another stand of corn that I planted in rows as we normally would. And in between the rows and among the corn, I planted beans here also. And as you can see, the corn is looking very, very good. I'm expecting some good corn this year. This is the first year I've done corn, and very satisfied with it. I have fertilized all of this with a what is a 12, 17, 12 fertilizer, because I wanted to encourage I the phosphorus and potassium encourages root growth, and I wanted to really wanted to encourage root growth in every in all of this, and it seems to have been a good choice this year. As you can see, corn's looking great, tasseling up well. Beans are looking well as too. I've already pulled out some of the beans, and if you saw my bean preparing my beans for freezer, this is where I got the beans from for that video. Well, folks, I hope you guys all enjoyed this. I hope you learned something. I hope that if you saw something that I could learn from, you'll leave a comment and let me know. Y'all have a good day. Bye.